Hi all, so I'm again here to present this topic, that is how to execute a SQL statement stored in IFS stream file using run SQL stm command in CLS wounded. So we can execute the SQL statement stored in a source member using this run SQL statement command that I have already created a video for that, and now I'm creating video for this one, that is when the SQL statements are stored at the IFS, then how we'll be doing this. So let me show you that demo. So this was the program which I written. So it's contain nothing and only a single command, run SQL command. So let me open this with option two, that is in edit mode. Let's take F4 here. So you will be seeing that I have not provided the details of source physical file and source member here, because now I'm gonna executing the SQL statements which are stored at the IFS. So I have to provide the file name which is stored at IFS. So I have to give the fully qualified path. So it's stored in /home/easy-class directory, and the file name is this one. So I have provided the full file name from the root. Now just copy that path till this. So to check this file at IFS, we will use this command work link and copy the and paste that path and press enter. Then take option 5 here. So you will be seeing, just delete this, you will be seeing this file. Just open this, take option 5 here. So you can see that now instead of source member, the SQL statements are stored in the IFS file. Create table this with no data, insert record this, then delete the record, then insert two records. So basically finally, once these SQL statements get executed one by one, we will have two records in this file. So this file would get created in Qtemp. So let's compile this, just check the Qtemp library. So there are no objects in Qtemp. Just call this program qnf42, then do dsplib again. Now you have pf1 in Qtemp. Just do run query on that. So you can see there are two records in this pf, which is the result of the execution of SQL statements stored at the IFS file. So let me show you how I created that file. So just do work link /home/easy-class/. So in any directory you can create a file, just take 5. So what you need to do is you need to write edtf command, take f4. So edit file, basically it will create a stream file in the directory which you provide. So let me provide /home. I can still create this file at the root, but I'm going till this path class. Now I want to give the file name, or even I can create a directory first. So for that purpose, I would have to use create dir command first to create a directory after this, because there is no directory after this. Then we can give the fully qualified including that directory. So this is the last point. Now I have to give the file name, just give qna42b. So you can see, you can now write the SQL statements here. So let me delete from qtemp /pf1, which I created, So I can separate each SQL statement by the semicolon. So I can again write some sort of statements just by using I can insert the new lines. So just save this. So for saving and exit, press F3. File has changed. Again press F3. Take F5 here. You will be seeing that file. Delete from qtemp/pf1. Or what we can do is just do this first. So your file name is qna42b. Now just copy this command again. Now you will be executing this one. So you can see you have data in PF1 in qtemp. Just call this program, call qna42 again. Now if you look at the data, you will find this file is empty since the delete statement gets triggered from the IFS using this run SQL command, run SQL STM command in CL program. Now you are left with this, you are left with this file. So you want to drop this table as well. So just go to that path and don't go to that path. You can directly use this command from here, edit file command. Now you will write drop table qtemp/pf1 f3 to save and exit 2 times. Now you need to call this program again because you didn't change any program, you only change the appended the SQL statements here. So it will pick all those SQL statements from there and will execute qna42. So you will not find any table in qtemp now. So you can see qtemp, that table is dropped. So this way you can execute the IFS stored SQL statements in a stream file from your run SQL STM command in CL program. So that's what I am to show here. So thank you and have a nice time.